Hello everyone. With you, Krivuli Andrew Charlie. In this video, we'll talk about how to transfer color from texture to fur in Octane Render for 3DSS Max. Also, I'll show you how to use the more advanced method of painting any part of your hair or fur in Ornatrix, and how to render it correctly in Octane Render. We will also test the rendering with the denoiser for the normal and the close-up view. Just a reminder that you can become a channel sponsor and get a 95% discount on all my assets, voiceovers in another language, etc. Also, if this is your first time on this channel and you want to know what it's about, as well as support me, watch the channel's trailer and read all the information in the attached commentary. And please, don't forget to like and subscribe. I would be very grateful for that. Now, let's go to watch this episode. So, for Octane, I took the same scene. And in Octane, unlike Redshift and V-Ray, which I have already shown, there are two ways to transfer color to fur. The first is the same as in Redshift and V-Ray. That is, first we need to create material. Press the right mouse button and select materials. Next, Octane and select hair material. Also, we need to create another node. For this, we go to maps. Next, Octane, image, RGB image. This node is needed to load your map. Then, connect it to the Albedo and Diffuse slots. Next, in the material itself, you must set the value equal to 0.5 for longitudinal roughness and azimuthal roughness. And the rest of the settings are left by default. Then, you can experiment with different settings, but I'm showing you the basics for now, just to make it work. After that, select the object with the fur and assign the material. Next, you need to make some adjustments to your objects in the scene. To do this, click the right mouse button and select Octane Properties. In the window that appears, activate the renderable option. Also, for all objects in the scene, you should activate the Movable Proxy option. Then, go to the Octane Render settings. There, go to the Kernel tab and for Notify Objects on Render, you need to activate the All Objects option. Thanks to this, on the render you will see 100% of the hair, even if in the viewport you will have 1% or less. The percentage is customized in hair from guides. Next, we upload our texture to the RGB image node. That is, click on None, opposite file name and select our map. As a result, we will see the desired color on the renderer. As you can see, everything is very simple and there is nothing complicated. The only thing that doesn't work in Octane is the smoothing of hair in the renderer. That is, they did not add an option here, as in other renders. But we have the Strand Detail modifier. In its settings, you can increase the number of points on the renderer, and at the result, you get smooth hairs. To see the changes, you will need to do a restart render. As a result, on the renderer, you will see a smooth result. And this was the first method of transferring color to fur in Octane Render. Of course, you can experiment with material settings and do whatever your soul desires. And now, I want to show you the second method, which works only in Arnold and Octane Render. This method is painting with color directly on the hairs. For example, here I want the tips to be green, here, the reds, and in this area, the yellow ones. This is not very convenient to do with the first method, because then you will need to spend a lot of time creating different gradients and masks. With the second method, which I am about to show you, this can be done much faster and more conveniently. So as not to put too much load on the 3DSS Max viewport, I will create a new object. That is, I will remove this fur. Next, I'll duplicate this plane. That is, I select it and press Ctrl plus V. In the window that appears, I choose Copy. Next, select this copy and assign OxEdit guides to it. This is done in order to use the Draw Strands tool to draw the guides. Choose this tool and draw any guides. Next, assign hair from guides to get hair. Then, we need clump to get the clumps by guides. To make it by guides, you need to select the appropriate option and click Create. Next, we need to remove the fraction and flyaway hairs, since we don't need it now. Then, it remains to turn on preserve strand length, and move forward. Now, we need to assign another edit guides, on top of all the modifiers, in order to be able to select the hair, and paint it in the desired color. By the way, you should consider one bug in Octane, which has not yet been fixed, and which may cause some inconvenience. That's why, you have to temporarily select Arnold Renderer, to make it work. And, you also need to temporarily assign the Arnold standard hair material. Thanks to this, you will see the selection of hair and its coloring in the viewport. So, when I was recording this tutorial, at the same time on the Octane Render forum, I was chatting with the developers. And they told me, that it is possible not to switch to Arnold Renderer, to make the selection work and display color in the viewport. As the developer, Neon Zorglub, writes, there are several Octane materials and standard scanline, that you can assign and everything will work. I'll leave you a link to this thread, so you can read the developer's reply. And now let's check what the developer suggested, in practice. As you already know, when the Octane hair material is assigned, we don't see the hair selection and the color paint. To solve this, we don't switch to Arnold Renderer. Now, click the right mouse button, go to Material, then Scanline and select Standard, Legacy. Next, we assign this material to our hair or fur. As a result, we see all the colors and of course the selection works. That is, if I switch to a normal channel without color, the selection works the same way. As you have already understood, it is enough to select the standard scanline material, and everything will work without a temporary switch to the Arnold Renderer. If for some reason, you don't have the standard material, you can use Octane Shadow Catcher. And with it, everything will work as well. That is, we can see the selection of hair, and if you switch to color display, everything will work. Let me even try to add some more color. But don't forget that when you want to render it, you have to assign Octane hair material again. Yes, everything will disappear in the viewport, but in the render we will see everything that we painted. This is the most important thing that the developers at OTOY told me. Yes, this is a temporary solution, and we are all together trying to find a fix for this bug with Octane hair material. In the meantime, you can use the solution I showed you. I would like to point out that this particular moment with the tips from OTOY, I recorded later than the lesson itself and what you will see next. So, in the lesson itself, yes, I show a temporary switch to the Arnold Renderer, but you already know you don't need to do that. Just choose Scanline or Octane Shadow Catcher instead of the one I show. All other actions are identical, so I continue the basic lesson. Now, let's figure out how to start hand dyeing selected hair. In order to paint on all hair or any selected area, you first need to enter the brush mode. Then, go to the tab with brushes and activate the paint brush. After that, go down below and find the Guide Channels tab. Next, in the Channel Display tab, turn on the Multi-Channel RGB option, so you can see all the channels when you paint the hair. Next, in the Current Channel tab, click Add 2 or 3 channels for painting. In the window that appears, be sure to select Per Vertex and write Color _ R. Immediately copy this name with Ctrl plus A, Ctrl plus C. And press the Add Channel button. We have only added the R channel, and now it remains to a G and B. Repeat the same operation with the Add button. Insert the copied name, and replace R with G. Press the Add Channel button again, and use the same actions to add color B. Then, in Current Channel, you have to select Color R. After that, go to Brush Options and select Color RGB for the Channels option. Next, choose any color, for example, yellow. Activate the paint brush and start painting with this color. I think you've already noticed the advantage of this method and noticed that only the parts where I painted were colored. For example, I can choose a different color and paint a different part of the hair anywhere. I want to pay your attention to the fact that when you paint over a selected object, the display of that color is slightly different. But don't worry, when you deselect, the color display will be correct. But now, I want to show you another cool thing about this method. For example, I will select this part of the hair, invert the selection and hide the rest of it. Let me edit this object a little bit. And for example, I want to paint this object into a different color. To paint only the selected object, you need to switch to brush mode and activate the effect selected only option. Next, I choose a paint brush and paint the tips in green and the roots in blue. Of course, remember that during the selection, the colors will be slightly different, and to see the natural color, you need to deselect. Now let's paint this part in yellow. But the cool thing isn't that you can dye the roots or the tip, and the fact that you can do some complex hair coloring in different places. After all, it would be more difficult to do this with normal nodes and textures. Now let's do and hide all and continue painting the rest of the hair. So, I want to fix this intersection. To do this, I'm going to select this part, come a little in the other direction, and then dye it in purple. Also, I will paint all the remaining gray parts. I think we can stop at this result. Since you remember that I assigned the Arnold material, I need to return the Octane hair material and continue the work. Assign Octane hair material again, remembering that in the viewport the color will disappear, but it will be available in the renderer. And return Octane render in the render settings. Keep in mind that I was recording this part until I got the advice from OTOY that I told you about earlier. So, if we run the renderer now, we won't see the color. To make the color work on the renderer, you need to add a special Octane node, which will take information from Ornatrix data about this color. To create this node, press the right mouse button and go to Maps. Next, select Octane, Geometric, Color Vertex Attribute. After that, connect this node to the Albedo and Diffuse slots. Then, select the created node, click on Common Attributes Names, and select Hair Color 1. Now, if we run the renderer, we will see all the colors that we painted. Therefore, you can dye your hair or fur in a more advanced way. Now, let's test the rendering speed on the first scene I showed. So, to start with, we need to do some rendering settings. Change the resolution to 1920x1080. Next, for the kernel type, choose path tracing, because then the quality of the hair will be better. Next, set 300 samples. Filter size is set to 1 to remove the blurring of details. Also turn on eye light in the eye light update, which speed up the calculation of lighting. Coherent ratio equals 0.6. Parallel samples and max tile samples are set to maximum to speed up calculations too. Be sure to turn on adaptive sampling because it also speeds up rendering. Also check if ray tracing is enabled. If not, then turn it on. And And, of course, we turn on denoising. To do this, you need to go to the Camera tab. And there, activate the Enable Denoising option. Close the settings and start the renderer. If you are not familiar with the status bar at the top, I recommend you check it out. It shows the number of samples, GPU memory, render time, and so on. You will need to wait a little bit, it is literally 1 minute, as the status bar shows. So, the renderer is done, and lets it a noise pass to see the amount of noise when rendering 300 samples. So, let's take a look at the beauty pass and the denoised beauty pass. In the end, we see that the denoiser has done its job, and 300 samples is enough for such a scene, and you can get a render in 1 minute. Let's also do a close-up rendering. Naturally, it will take a little longer to render this view. So, the rendering time is 3 minutes 46 seconds. This is how Beauty Pass looks at 100% scale. And this is how Denoise Beauty looks like. That is, even for a close-up, 300 samples with a denoiser is enough. If you liked this video, don't forget to write about it in the comments, put a like and subscribe to the channel. To be continued, see you soon. Peace, everybody. If this is your first time on this channel, then here, you can learn all the tricks and secrets of 3D grooming in Ornatrix. Also, get your questions answered and get inspired by references from the games. Subscribe and write in the comments how long you do 3D and why you chose this field. What influenced this? If you like what I do, I would be very grateful for any donation to PayPal at the link in the description. Buying my models on CG Trader or ArtStation. As well as the purchase of any of the plugins at the links in the attached commentary. What's in it for you? It's very simple. If enough money is collected per month, I will be able to devote my full time to creating lessons for you, not 3 hours a day. Which, as you have already noticed, not enough for the first release of new episodes. Also, don't forget to check out the YouTube community, as I share there all kinds of news, uploading answers to questions, talking about the time spent time on lessons, and so on. And, of course, don't forget about my Instagram, where I upload all my work and work in progress.